Friday night show. It's Friday. I just get the feeling that this audience is patronizing me just a little bit. Like, I'm not stupid. I know this crap isn't funny. I think we're in luck now, because my first guest is an actor. How unusual for a late-night talk show. An actor, you say, on a late-night talk show? Has this been done before? No, we thought we'd give it a try. He's in a new film, Underworld, Rise of the Lycans. The Lycans, if you don't know, are from the planet Glabella. The movie's in theaters now. Take a look at this. Oh. Michael Sheen, everybody. Michael Sheen. Hello, Michael.
Hello.
Welcome back. It's lovely to see you again.
Thank you very much.
And that looks very interesting, the old underpants film. What's that?
Yeah. You, looks very hairy, doesn't it?
You're very hairy
very
in that
hairy.
Film. Do you, are you that hairy in your own life?
I can grow it at will.
You know, do you ever grow hair in your glabella?
I've had a lot of things in my glabella. Hair being one of them.
I'll bet you have, right?
Makes no sense.
However, listen, I know, I congratulations on the Underworld film and the hairiness and everything, but the Frost Nixon, I just saw it. It's spectacular. Oh. It really is spectacular. But you and Frank, in fact, everybody in the movie, but you and...
Especially Frank Glabella.
Frank Glabella,
playing
yes,
Nixon,
that's
yeah.
How unusual to be named after the space. I liked it because, you know, well, you grew up in Britain, didn't you?
I did.
So did I.
Yeah.
And everybody could do a David Frost impression when I was growing up.
Well, everyone thinks they can do a David Frost.
Yes, that's right. And you touched on that in the film, I suppose, when everybody would come up to him and do that, and he would say, I don't do that. What was
everyone wants to do one to me as well.
Oh, can I?
And they wanted to do one to me before, when people heard that I was playing Frost.
Right.
And they'd come up to me and do it, and which, of course, puts a lot of pressure on, because most people were better at it than me.
Oh, you're pretty good at it. Do you want to have a quick Frost-off?
Should we have a Frost-off?
Yeah, wait, All right, well, I'll go first, because I'm the challenger.
Okay.
All right, then. All right. Hello, good evening, and welcome. Yeah.
Okay. I'd give that a 6 out of 10.
Okay, maybe? Yeah. I'm under a lot of pressure here. Okay. I don't have time for
that. I could give you the young Frost, or I could give you the old Frost.
Oh. Let's try young first.
Young Frost, okay. Hello, good evening, and welcome.
Wow.
Yeah. Very good.
Was that the young Frost or the I didn't know he was gay Frost?
That was Frost going into Austin Powers a little bit.
The film did have little moments of Austin Powers.
I think Austin Powers is slightly based on David Frost.
Yeah, a little bit, I think.
That sort of Playboy jet set.
That scene where you're in the jumbo jet and you're talking to that fabulous bird, baby. It's like,
smoking a cigar, drinking champagne.
That's when life was life, when you could get hammered and smoke cigars on airplanes.
Exactly. Yeah. I still do.
Do you really?
Yeah, it's why I'm not allowed into America very often.
No, you're not allowed to do it on American airplanes anymore. You can't smoke and drink cigars. No. You can't even smoke cigars. Anyway.
You can't smoke champagne or drink cigars either.
No, you can't. But that's the laws of physics. That's nothing
that's
to do.
That's true.
Yeah. Now, the Underworld movie, what's that about? Is it about the underworld?
Well, it is about the underworld, world that is under. This is the third one in the series, and this goes back in time. It's a prequel, so it shows the origins of the whole story. It goes back. It's about an ages-long feud between werewolves and vampires.
Oh, yeah. Well, of course, they are notoriously at each other's throats most of the time.
Exactly.
And you would be a werewolf then?
I am a werewolf. And because the two films are out sort of at the same time, Frost Nixon and Underworld, I know a lot of the reviews for both films were on the same page. And I was trying to think about what the journalists would put as the headline for both reviews.
Right.
So there's obviously Interview with a Vampire.
Right.
Could be one that covers both.
Right.
But my favorite one is Frost Bites.
Oh, nice! does it mean the movie Bites or does it mean the...
I don't know. I don't even know what it means.
But do you believe in the undead and the walking? You know, because I do.
I I have quite a few members of my family that I believe are under.
Yeah, no,
in fact, bizarrely, and this is not a joke, in my dressing room here, there's a coffin. Did you just get that for me? Was that some sort of practical... There is actually a coffin in my dressing room.
No, that's my dressing room.
Oh, that's your... Oh, that'll be why.
No, so what happened was that this studio here is right next to where Bob Barker used to host The Price is Right. Shut up. And Bob Barker is a notorious vampire. So what Bob would do between shows is he would rest in the soil of his native land in the... and then he'd come out and you know... I don't know. Why is there a coffin lying around? That is frightening.
Is it just to freak people out before they come on the show?
You know, I never thought of doing it, but it is a good idea.
It worked with me.
Well, I'm sure it did. I think that would be terrifying to walk in and find a coffin in your dressing room.
Exactly.
I had planned on something completely different. Poisonous spider, I was going to put in for you. How very odd.
I'd heard that people die on this show, but...
Oh, yeah, I know. Every night when I do the monologue, my friend... What about the Underworld movie? It's kind of a sci-fi thing. Do you end up at the sci-fi conventions? Do you go around and...
I'd love to. I'd love to end up in a sci-fi convention. I was hopeful... There's one called ComicCon, which is...
Oh, that's the huge one. San Diego it was.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you very much. Surprise you guys were at ComicCon.
And I couldn't go there because I was a bit ill whilst it was on.
Oh, what was wrong?
I was a bit poorly.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
What, do you have a hangover?
I was poorly, yeah. No, I was poorly in Britain. Which is a whole different thing than being poorly here. And so I couldn't... Well, you'd have to get on a plane, wouldn't you?
Oh, I see. You had tummy troubles.
Yeah, all that kind of stuff.
You couldn't get on the plane with your...
So I missed out on Comic-Con. But I'd have loved... Because, like, science fiction and fantasy stuff is my favourite stuff.
Really?
Absolutely. My favourite writers, Stephen King, Neil Gaiman, people like that.
Do you like Ian Banks?
The Scottish writer?
Yes, he's very good.
He has two versions of his
name. Yeah, when he writes regular books, he's Ian Banks. When he writes science fiction books, he's Ian M. Banks. Although I don't know anything about science fiction. I'm not a geek, not me.
If your monologue goes well, are you known as Craig Ferguson? And if it doesn't go well, Craig P. Ferguson?
No. If my monologue goes well, Craig Ferguson. If it goes badly, I'm Conan O'Brien, everybody. I'm over right back.